going through your mind now, Ashwin?
I'm just thinking how I'm going to recover and just sleep through the night. That is all I'm thinking about right now.
It's a real dream, isn't it? In the morning, you said playing 4 test matches on your home soil is a great feeling. But what you did today was something spectacular.
Yeah, look, I mean, even after the last test, we were talking about how we were going to counter Leach and, you know, start probably bringing the sweep to the game. The last time I was sweeping was when I was 19 years old and I hit a couple of sweep shots, got dropped from the side and never played a sweep for the last 11, maybe 13, 14 years. Been practicing only that shot for the last week to 10 days and I'm very, very thankful that the plans really paid off. The wicket's such that you got to get your run square of the pitch and yeah, sort of had a very, very good day. I think we posted a really good score. Now we can really attack with men around the bat.
But how difficult is to play this particular shot in 3 days' time? How to get the control and master it?
I can't really say that it's been happening in the last 3 days. It's been happening for a while. We've been practicing along with Vikram Rathore. Vikram Rathore has been pretty, very, very helpful in terms of trying to explore new options. I'm, as it is, someone who tries a lot, and he's someone who's facilitating me to be able to go out there and express myself, explore various options. In fact, I'd like love to credit him for how my batting has gone through over the last 4 or 5 test matches. He's kept me in the loop. He said I've been batting very well. Not to overthink it, just look at game plans. And I'm really thankful it's happened at my home ground. I don't know if I'm going to play another test. I don't know when the next test is going to be here, but I'm super pleased.
Well, we saw when you were in the 70s, you upped the ante and you were willing to go over the top. Something unusual from you?
No, not really. I think in the past, when I've made my hundreds in India, Ishi has been a cog in the wheel. He's been with me twice when I made 100, so he sort of understands how I go about it. Ishi was defending pretty well, so I thought I need to take calculated risks as long as he was there. But once Siraj came, I knew I had to get it done in a few overs. But I was super thrilled the way he batted and hit the ball out of the ground towards the end.
What were you telling Mohammad Siraj? Was he listening to you in the first place?
No, I was just saying, I mean, look at the line of the ball and go for that side wherever you feel like it. And every time he slogged on over mid-wicket, he was like, I'll go with the spin now. The bowler is probably expecting me to go across the line. So it's quite a funny thing. And it was amazing to see how excited he was when I got my 100. So that says a thing or two about how the dressing room is. We've really lived a dream over the last 2 to 3 months, I must say.
Well, the position that you were in, you were a fighting team and he came back very strongly. The team might be mighty pleased.
Yeah, I think I really don't know what the team is feeling like because I've been in the park for the last 8 days, literally in the 2 test matches. I've just been out there, so I don't really know how they're feeling, but I'm sure they're really, really thrilled. I think the moment I got my runs, I was seeing everybody up in the balcony, and I can't really thank the crowd enough. They've been wonderful. They've really been very, very supportive of me. Every time I walked out to bat or bowled, the applause has been really, really thunderous.
You're a tired man. Thanks for sparing some time and talking to us.